मॉर्निंग सर, आई एम आशीष कुमार फ्रॉम बीटेक फाइनल ईयर। इट्स माई प्लेजर टू इंट्रोड्यूस माई टॉपिक फॉर द प्रेजेंटेशन, सेटिंग ऑफ कट पॉइंट। बिफोर वी गेट स्टार्टेड, आई वुड जस्ट लाइक टू टेल अ ब्रीफ अबाउट द आउटलाइन ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन। आई वुड फर्स्ट टेल अबाउट द बेसिक्स ऑफ डिस्टिलेशन, दैट इज वॉट इज डिस्टिलेशन एंड हाउ डू वी परफॉर्म दैट। देन वी आई विल कम आउट फॉर डिस्टिलेशन मेथड्स एंड देन वी विल हैव अ डिटेल्ड डिस्कशन ऑन कट पॉइंट। So that's all that is I'm going to present in this PPT, and we will move forward. So first we know about distillation is that it is the method of separating components based on relative volatility, and distillation is basically dependent on the distribution of substances between two phases, that is gas and liquid. And if we talk about the ways in which distillation can be done, so there are basically two methods or two ways. The first one being production of vapor by boiling the liquid mixture that we have to separate, and then we condense the vapor without allowing any reflux. And the second method being we take out a part of condensate to the still under such conditions, and then the returning liquid is brought into contact with the way to condenser. If we talk about the hydrocarbon, that is for example gasoline, which is a mixture of various hydrocarbons, so different components boil at different temperatures. So basically we get a fraction in which all the petroleum products get boiled corresponding to their boiling temperature. So here we know that here we have to determine that what is the volatility of fuel that we are using. So there are basically three methods employed for this purpose. The first one being ASTM distillation, abbreviated for American Society for Testing Materials. The second one being equilibrium flask vaporization, and the third one being true boiling point distillation, that is abbreviated as TBP. Now we will discuss one by one each methods. ASTM or American Society for Testing Materials distillation is a standard test method that is used for distillation of petroleum products at pressure equal to atmospheric pressure. And the basic purpose for this method is to calculate the property and correlations for distillate fractions for various refinery products. As we can see in the rightmost corner of the slide, there is a distillation curve, ASTM distillation curve, that basically representing three groups of petroleum products named as group 1, group 2 and group 3. And all of these products are basically plotted on the basis of temperature and the percent of evaporation. So here we see that the blue line tops the list, and it is indicating that the oil is heavy, whereas the green line and red line are below it, where the green line indicates that the oil is less volatile, and hence we can use it for aviation purpose. Now we will discuss the second method. Equilibrium flask vaporization or EFV. It involves heating a flowing feed and separation of liquid and vapor in a flask drum. So here we can plot a distillation curve based on the conduction of this distillation at various temperatures. And the specific purpose of EFV is to calculate process the design calculations for equipment for the separation of multi-component hydrocarbon mixtures. And it is also used to predict VLE, that is vapor liquid equilibrium relations, for mixtures of various unknown compositions at various temperatures and varying the amount of evaporation or vaporization. So EFV provides useful data for flashing operations in the refinery. Now in the end we will discuss about true boiling point distillation. So it is also a concerned topic because we are going to have the study of cut point, that is basically belonging from this topic only. So TBP distillation is used to characterize crude oils and constitute a significant component of crude assay. And in the graph we can see that TBP or true boiling point curve is above the ASTM and EFV for cumulative volume percentage of around 45, and it also shows that it achieves a higher degree of separation than ASTM, and ASTM further is better than EFB. So the best method for this evaluation or this characterization is the TBP curve. So we will now discuss the topic, that is cut point. So a cut point is basically indicates that the temperature difference between the separation border between two crude oil fractions, and it is the temperature which below which all of the light fractions constituent will boil, and the heavier fractions would have the initial boiling point, or the temperature at which all of the heavier fractions component will boil. Now by changing the cut point, we can change the yield of two adjacent fractions, resulting in more of one or less of the other. So here we define a swing cut, which is the range over which the refiner normally swings the cut point. Cut point can be said to be the temperature that indicates the limitations, because as we discussed, it indicates the temperature between the separation boundaries. So it indicates it's the limitation of a distillate fraction when we plot a TBP curve. So for example, if we consider kerosene and name the lower cut point to be TA and upper point to be TB, then we can calculate the yield percent for in volume term percent for each distillate fraction by taking the volume at TA and volume at TB and then subtracting them. So we get 20 volume percent for the kerosene. Now the temperature on the crude oil cumulative TBP curve defines the yield of distinct cuts known as cut points, that is naphtha, kerosene, gas oil residue, etc. Now if we see the naphtha TBP cut point, it comes out to be around 220 degrees Celsius. For example, we can read a cumulative yield of C1 to 20 degrees Celsius fraction from the curve, which corresponds to the selected 220 degrees C. So this does not imply that your CDU naphtha will have the same endpoint. It will be slightly higher depending on the fractionation efficiency between naphtha and the next product of your atmospheric tower. It also shows that the initial boiling point of the adjacent product will most likely be less than 220 degrees Celsius. So there isn't a complete separation between adjacent incisions. And in the graph, we can see that TB curve is plotted and cut points are present for different petroleum products, that is naphtha, kerosene, light gas oil. And here we can also see that vacuum gas oil and heavy gas oil are also plotted, and TE and TB, these denote the indicate the limitations of the boiling points, that is TE and TA are the separation limits. Now we will study the TB cut point for various fractions, and we get the experimental values as for the distillate product like light steam reforming naphtha, the boiling rate comes out to be 90 to 190 degree Fahrenheit, indicating that naphtha is the lowest boiling fraction, while heavy naphtha comes out to be slightly higher, that is 190 to 380 degree Fahrenheit. Kerosene comes around 380 to 520 degree Fahrenheit, and then light gas oil comes around 520 to 610 degree Fahrenheit. Heavy gas oil comes out to be around 610 to 800 degree Fahrenheit, while the remaining fractions, that is light vacuum gas oil, comes out to around 800 to 940 degree Fahrenheit, and heavy vacuum gas oil comes out to around 950 to 1850 degrees Fahrenheit, and vacuum residue comes out around 1050 degree Fahrenheit, indicating that vacuum residue is the heaviest boiling fraction. So the data is indicating that as we go down the list, we can see that the boiling point of the component is increasing. That is indicating that the heaviness of the fraction would be greater as we go down the list. And if we take out the first component of the list, then that would be the lightest boiling oil. That means the, it will boil at relatively lower temperature as compared to the adjacent ones or the below ones. With this, I would like to conclude my discussion on cut point, and I would like to thank you, Sasikant sir, for this exciting